Good evening, everyone. Thank you for having me tonight. And this is my honor to be here on the stage to share with you the topic, entertain yourself, but don't waste your time. In the book, Amusing Ourselves to Death, the author Neil Postman has mentioned that when the media reaches to the status of super multimedia, it will not only direct our perception about the world, it will also determine our whole understanding of it. So the book was published in 1985. It was even before the blooming eras of internet and social media. But I think it has foreseen the future of what we call the super multimedia, when the giant like Facebook, TikTok, YouTube, and Google have a dominant and a critical role in feeding news, content, information, and entertainment stuff to their audience, I mean the internet user, which occupy 2/3 of our population. So based on what the media provide, our perception about the world could be positive or negative to a certain extent. And then it decides what we think and how we feel about our life. That's why I think it's very important. It's very essential for us to build a solid awareness of assessing and of consuming the information. Simply because information is like food. We are what we eat. The people we meet, the source of information that we turn to, the content that we consume, will define who we are. Let's say, if you're feeling like your life is full of negative energy or contents, chance that you're letting yourself falling into the tangles, into the traps, the circles of negative consumption. What is it? The circles or the bubble was built by the technique of social media, of filtering, of data personalization, of machine learning, and of navigational mechanism. So the algorithm behind the social media had learned about your interest through the way that you behave on the social media, and it make recommendation. So if you watch a lot of negative and sensationalized contents, it tend to fit you more and more of negative and sensationalized media, right? So this circle, it's like a vortex, will plunge you deeper and deeper into the tangle of fake news and false information, of sensationalized and fragmented, of biased content. So you'll go numb, and you start like losing your consciousness. And before you know it, your worldview is filled with negativity, with drama, with showbiz and political conspiracy and tabloids. Okay, I think that there's a point that we all can agree that in that digital age, we are kind of like overloaded with information, right? Because there has never been a time in the humanity that has experienced the abundance of information. The social media feed us the content with only one click. We just enter and everything will appear. But more important, it even provided the content without any click or saying what we want. Yes, I'm mentioning about the recommendation system of the social media, Facebook, YouTube, Google, and especially TikTok, the youngest but the smartest one, the application that have 1.6 billion users, and the fastest growing application of history. I think TikTok have the smartest recommendation system. You choose the video to bob up on your feed based on the content you like, the video you watch, and the way that you interact with each kind of content is really brilliant. I think TikTok even understand me more than my lover, more than myself. Okay, it's not only TikTok. It is like talking about social media. Each adult have, I think, average 7.5 social media account based on the status of Statista. And they spend at least 2.5 hours a day surfing on the social media. So the amount of information that modern human exchange and perceive every day is 1,455 times greater than we used to 1,000 years ago. While our brain doesn't doubling in size every year, right? So we are facing a frustrated and inevitable reality why the brain storage does not have enough space to store more information, why the processor chip may not upgrade it fast enough to process all the information it received. So it means like it can't differentiate between the good and bad, between the fake and real, between the related and irrelevant contents. So if the inaccurate data find way into application, it may lead to the mistake in perception, in action. It will cause some damages in psychological and physical to us and to the people around. So information in channel, I think, is could be a tools for navigation and for manipulation, while unsuspected user may find themselves increasingly mired in a poor mental health condition, lack of social connection and social skill. So as an insider of that business who had built a career out of creating content, creating public feature and an influencer, I may have some advice for you, especially the younger, the young people here. It may be very simple, I think, but you could apply it every day when you're surfing on the social media. So first, before you let in yourself, letting your subconscious mind, your social media and their algorithm breed in you and drive you, drive it, take the wheel. So while scrolling on the social media, keep asking yourself this simple yes, no question. Okay, let's start with, is this information useful? If no, skip it. Okay, if yes, does really make your life happier and positive? If no, skip it. Is it information coming from a reliable sources? If no, skip it. Okay, so you can add in more questions into that diagram to create a funnel of filtering the information coming to you. So that's very simple command, could be a very powerful tool for you to take back the control from the algorithm, who is very good at reading your mind, right? And it also is a very necessary pause for you before you receive in any information, I think. The second one, build a healthy circle. So there's a famous saying, the sparrow near school seen the pram. This means that the circle of friends, the circle of information in your environment will shape who you are, right? So in that virtual world, you need to choose the virtual friend to trust, the celebrities, the people to follow, the channel to supply, and the content to consume. And that circle will shape you, because there's a circle that warms you, and that circle will squeeze and put you deeper into the cold. So say yes to the source of information that's healthy, that's trustworthy, that's informative and aligned with your direction. And keep saying no with the content and the source of information that's not aligned with that. So don't get me wrong, the social media give you a lot of tools to say no, but we often skip that. We can rate it, report it, say that we're not comfortable with that content, and keep telling the platform and teach them to understand you more and help them to filter in the circle for you. So the first one, the second one, will help you to build a circle and then a filter funnel so that you can filter your information. The third one, you check the sources. So that's a very basic one, but I think we often overlook it because we are often swayed by the appealing and the appearance of the information, more than checking for the value and validation of the sources. So in an age where the social media empower the user by giving them the freedom to create content and to distribute the content freely, without any tool for the audience to fact check the information, it can flood you with a huge amount of fake news and false information. And then it will get you into a wrong sequence of results due to the inaccurate initiate data. The question is it sources just worthy? Is it likely biased? Where did this source come from? And what's the true history of these sources? Is it really authentic? Okay, the fourth one, don't pay attention to comment. I know that is the most challenging one. Anyone here like reading comment? Raise your hand. Okay, I know everyone loved opening the comment section of any TikTok video or any social boss, right? Me the same. It's the most interesting. It's the most fun one. Like everybody was so free to express their idea and their opinion. But no one can check, can verify the authenticity of those comments. No one could tell you that's a fact or just opinion. Someone drawing it online spontaneously, and you are the one who take it seriously. Okay? So reading them can also make you like easily cough up in the pointless, free argument, angry, and anxious. And reading comment also can create prejudice and biased judgment over the topic, even though that you're not really engaging and validating the source of information. And also, remember that if an opinion disguised as fact has fit into you over and over again, your brain may automatically count them as fact. The fifth one. I think let's introduce yourself to more and more long form of information. Book, newspaper, podcast, anything that methodically produced, extensively researched, reviewed, and published would be more likely a reliable sources of information. And also, you should like limit yourself on the time that you're spending on the short form content, the Facebook and TikTok. In my case, I have a principle for myself. I call it like 70 and 30. So it means that if I spend 30 minutes on the short form contents, like surfing on TikTok, it's really fun. And then I spend 70 minutes on reading a book or on the other long form content that interests me. So, why am I the CEO of an entertainment company that financially benefits from content consumption, would give you the advice and tell you that be mindful when consume the content online? Because I think just like all the people in my industry, I want to create a content that added value for my audience, not just getting the revenue stream for the producer. So if you decided to be a part of the game, to be a content creator, which is, I think, very easy to be today, you can very easy to create a TikTok account, right? It's really easy to be a content creator, but it's very hard to be a good one. So please keep remember four things. First, you need to put yourself in the perspective of the viewer. Think about what they get from your content. The second one, define your mission and your core value. It's like you create a brand and a company. Define the mission and the core value for creating and distributing content. Keep asking yourself the reason why you need to create it and share it, and the reason why the viewer have to watch your content. The third one, always fact check yourself. Make sure that you share the authentic content, right? And the last one would be you regularly check on your audience to make sure that the message that you want to deliver are aligned and related to the target audience of your channel. So those seemingly very easy and very simple things will be very hard for you to follow, because it is not easy to not compromise with the trap of view of engagement from the sensationalized content. For a long time, the media producer and consumer often stand on the opposite end, arguing and blaming each other for the harmful consequences of the media consumption. But you know, the media, the social media nowadays has blurred the line between the content production and consumption. It is tricky to dictate who is accountable for the bad thing that happened because of what being shared on the internet. But still, I think it's worthwhile to pursue the healthy content consumption. Even that you are a media producer, a consumer, be mindful. Because the war against the harmful media consumption will require a lot of collaborative effort, perseverance, and participation. Thank you.